Are they really from hell? No, but they might as well be. Sharks, the 2018 novel by Chris Jamieson. This is the second novel in Jamieson's collection of stories, but it is not a sequel to Shark Island, though it is just as much of a page-turner. The plot: a group of people head off on a Hawaiian retreat via sailboat. Their host, Harry, soon fills them in on why he's trying to rekindle their friendship after ending it on a bad note years prior. When they arrive at a Coast Guard station to pay respect to Harry's deceased father, they run into a snag. One of them is injured by a mysterious man on the island, and they have to make it back to their vessel. Too bad a group of modern-day pirates are approaching. So how do the sharks fit into the story? Well, the pirates have been tossing their victims into a certain spot, and now the sharks are used to eating anything that moves in that area. I like the idea about as much as I like the characters. Thankfully, despite some gripes, I really did enjoy the characters in this book. Alex and his wife, Sammy, are the two main characters, and their strong relationship makes for great chemistry. They are a married couple with a daughter at home. Several times she is mentioned as motivation for them. Harry is the cause for the group's departure. They were all in a tight-knit friendship with each other. One of the friends committed suicide, and that led to some less than appropriate comments from Harry. He tries to make amends, but sometimes you can't change people by shoving money in their faces and taking them on exotic trips. Sometimes. I mentioned the pirates and the plot as if they were a huge part of the story. More like a huge inconvenience. During the story, they only have up to 50 pages of scenes. You just know the group will run into them, and their ominous lack of presence is somewhat unsettling. When they do arrive, they are wasted. I hate to say it, but so much more could have and should have been done with them. Also, the book just kind of ends. No major spoilers, but there is no real resolution for anything. It kind of left me sour. The title, Devil Sharks, is a reference to the native word they use to describe the sharks in the area. They are not supernatural or anything, they're just mean and have a nasty presence about them. I do have to say, I love Jamieson's style of writing. He doesn't reveal too much about the characters too fast. Sammy is actually a black character, and it's only mentioned once in passing. For all those people who want equality in every story, then look no further. Shark Island had a lesbian couple, and so Devil Sharks has a gay couple. Hooray. It doesn't change anything in the story. It's kind of a pointless character trait. This is a fast-paced read. I read it in 3 days, and with nearly 300 pages, I'd consider that a pretty good amount of time. It only drags if you're not invested in the characters. I was, so it worked for me. The gore, not as gory as his first book in terms of shark attacks. The red water is present, but the only scene of a violent shark attack wasn't actually that graphically described. Most of the gore comes from grisly bullet hits from gunshots. This is a step down from Shark Island, but not by too much. With great pacing and characters that did bicker a bit, but not too much, and they did so within reason, I'd say this book is worth checking out. Just don't go hoping for a masterpiece. It's got a B-grade story written all over it. Overall, I give Devil Sharks a 3 out of 5. I am Brian Gatto, host of Horror Show Entertainment. Make sure to like my Facebook page in the description below, leave comments, and subscribe.